Hallelujah. Glory be to God forever and forever. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Thank you. Thank you. I want to put this up here. If it's gonna stand. Okay, it does stand. So how are you guys doing? Happy Sunday. In the name of Jesus, I wanted to share with you today about the grace of God. The Bible says that we are saved by grace through faith. But I love one special scripture that is spoken in the book of Galatians. It is Galatians 2:21. It says that I do not, let me show you the scripture. I like showing the scriptures by reading it. 1 minute. I do not frustrate the grace of God. For if righteousness come by the law, then Christ died in vain. Let's read it again together. What is happening? It's not showing. Okay. You are talking here about, I think it is dark. 1 second, let me clean it up. Be less. 1 minute. It's not showing well. What is going on? Okay, let me see. Yeah, okay, now it's good. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. But it's not I that live, yet not I, but Christ living me. And the life which I live now in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me, he gave himself for me. Then verse 21 is what I want to emphasize on. I do not frustrate the grace of God, for if righteousness come by the law, or maybe if righteousness come by what I can do, or maybe I do something good, or righteousness can come by I keep all the law, then Christ died in vain. So that's what I want to be about, because there are so many people who are frustrating the grace of God. So Paul was saying that I don't want to frustrate. So I want to talk about people frustrating the grace of God in the body of Christ. That means they are looking backward in the old covenant. We are not old covenant Christian anymore. In the old covenant, the prophets, the apostles, every one of them were looking for Jesus Christ to go to the cross. They were standing on this other side of the cross. Everybody was looking, oh, Jesus will go to the cross. From Genesis to the cross, the whole old covenant, Abraham, everybody were waiting for Jesus Christ to come and go to the cross so that he can redeem the human race. Amen? In Jesus' name. But if you can do something, keep the law, and then you do something before you get the blessing, then Christ dies in vain. That's what he's trying to say. If you can be righteous, you can be smart, you can do your own stuff, then Christ dies in vain. That every religion can just go to heaven by doing something. So I want to talk about frustrating the grace of God. The Holy Spirit told me about how so many people are frustrating the grace of God, even calling it cheap grace. They are calling it cheap grace. God's grace is not cheap. So anybody who is calling God's grace cheap is frustrating the grace of God. So don't frustrate the grace of God in your life, because you cannot do anything to go to heaven. You cannot keep the law. The Bible says that the law is for the lawbreakers. It's not for us who are in Christ Jesus. We are not under the law. We are under God's grace. So we don't frustrate the grace of God, because the Bible even talks about how sin cannot have dominion over us anymore. Amen. Because I see so many people, they are just behaving as if Jesus has not died for sin. As if he did not die for our own nature to take it to the cross and crucify it. As if Jesus did not die to destroy the works of the devil. The devil has fooled so many Christians and so many people. They think that, okay, you are saved, then you have to do the works. You have to do some works again. That scripture says that, you know, you have to work your own salvation. Some people think that, oh, you have to do something before then you can be really. That means it's just as if Jesus Christ's work was not enough. Jesus' job was enough. The work that Jesus did on Calvary, the Bible says it is finished. It was enough. So you have to renew your mind by going to the Word of God and really reading it, so you don't frustrate the Spirit of grace, which is the Holy Ghost. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So there are so many Christians who believe that Jesus Christ They believe that, like, as if Jesus died on the cross. Yes, but if you sin, then you have to then pay for your own sin again. No. The Bible says Jesus is an advocate now for us. And he has seen it, even not the advocate for us, but for the whole world. So if you sin, you confess your sin because the work has been done. Confess your sin. He is faithful and just to forgive your sin and cleanse you from all unrighteousness. So you have to remember that Jesus was made sin for us who knew no sin, so that you should be made the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Now, when you are born again Christian, you are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. You are holy. You are unblameable before God's eye. That is just how it is. I know sometimes you'll be feeling, because the devil will want to make you say, oh no, I'm not righteous. I'm not a new creation anymore. It was just, you just as if you'll be thinking, oh, today I'm saved. Tomorrow I'm not saved. Today I'm in the spirit. Tomorrow I'm in the flesh. Oh, today I am a born again Christian. Tomorrow I'm an old creation. Today, it is not like that. It is so much confusion. That is not like that. You are one saved forever. Your spirit is saved forever. Your soul, which is your mind, your intellect, and your will, has to be renewed. You have to renew your mind. Your body, this body does not change. Your old nature that used to cause you to sin, that used to create sin, that is like a devilly nature, was crucified with Christ on the cross when you come to Calvary. So nevertheless, it is not you living again. It is Christ living his life now in you. So you have to remember that all the time. If not, the devil will defeat you all the time. He will keep you in that state where you are up, down. Oh, today I feel the Holy Ghost. Tomorrow I don't feel the Holy Ghost. Now I see so many Christians who are just following feeling. They are not following the word of God and the promises of God. They feel today, oh, I'm righteous because I feel holy. Then tomorrow I don't feel righteous. That is all. It's not like that. It's not like that. The Holy Spirit says, I will never leave you or forsake you. He's always there. He will never leave you. Whether you feel good or you don't feel good, you are, the Holy Ghost is there. Whether you are sick or you are not sick, he is there. You are a born again Christian. You are safe. You are not under the law. You are under God's favor and under God's grace. So you are not the old covenant Christian. Again, that you have to say, okay, I have to do something before I can get the blessing. The Bible says you are already blessed with all spiritual blessing in Christ Jesus. It's not because you have to do something or you go keep Deuteronomy 28 or you do some kind of thing before you will be blessed. No, it is not like that. In the new creation, the new covenant, you are already blessed. The Bible says if you be Christ, you are Abraham's seed and you are joined here according to the promise. You are not under the curse anymore. You are under God's blessing. You are already blessed. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So you have been made free from sin. That's what the Bible says in the book of Romans. Romans 6 is talking there in verse 22. It's talking that you have been made free from sin. He said, but now being made free from sin, you have become a servant of God. And now you have the fruit unto holiness, and the end is everlasting life. You have been made free from sin because the wages of sin is dead, right? For those who are in the world. But the free gift of righteousness, the free gift of God, is eternal life, and that comes only through Jesus Christ. So if you become a born again Christian, you have that free gift of righteousness. So Galatians say, do not, I cannot. So for me, I declare all the time that I cannot frustrate the grace of God in my life, because if righteousness come by my doing, that I do good today, or I do this, or I don't do that, or do that, then righteousness, then that means Christ died in vain. Then today I will be like, oh well, I have to go and start performing all the things that they were performing in the old covenant. I'll have to go and perform all what was performed, so that if I don't perform all those things in that Deuteronomy 28, oh yeah, I will be cursed. Then the curse will come out on me, and if I perform it, then I will get the It's not like that. You are already blessed in Christ. In Christ, you are already blessed with all spiritual blessings. Jesus became a curse for you so that you can be blessed. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So I just want you to be looking forward, not always looking backward. In the old covenant, as if Jesus did not go to the cross. So those people will do that, will behave as if Jesus has not died, as if Jesus has not gone to the cross. They are frustrating the grace of God in the name of Jesus Christ. So after you come to Christ, you will still struggle. That is what I wanted to tell you. Some of you will struggle different different stuff. When you are born again Christian, you will be struggling with different stuff. Maybe with cigarette, maybe with fornication, with some different things. It does not mean that your spirit is not born again. Your spirit is born again, but the Holy Spirit is still there to clean the fish. Renew your mind slowly, slowly, slowly with the word of God, especially if you are reading the new covenant. That is all these new the letters that Paul wrote to the new creation. If you read that, you'll be renewing your mind before you see them, then those bondages will be falling out. It doesn't mean that if you come to Christ, you will not have any struggle. That's what some Christians they think. And then they keep going to places. Oh, touch me and let me fall. That when I fall, I get the experience of the Holy Ghost a little bit, and that all my problem will finish. Your problem will not finish. Your problem finish when you renew your mind. The Bible says my people are destroyed because of lack of knowledge. You have to renew your mind. And then when you renew your mind, you know the truth. And then that is when the truth will make you free. You cannot be free without knowing the truth. You can go now to any pastor, they touch you, you fall down, you feel the Holy Ghost, you hear the experience, all that. You go home, the demons will come back because they know that those places in your life, so a section in your life, you have not got the truth. The truth is in the word of God. And that is what will make you free. I don't say that deliverance is not good. There are deliverance that is good in the situation that you can be in a serious kind of bondage that you nobody can help. I mean, you yourself cannot help to deliver yourself. Then somebody can pray for you, cast out the devil. Then you can now get a clear mind now to start to read the word of God so that you can understand it. But it doesn't mean that you, when they give you that touch and all that thing, that is all. As far as you are walking on the face of this earth, which is the devil's kingdom, you will see be getting his fairy dart attack and here and there. That is why the Bible says that we as we are walking this earth, we have to put the whole armor of God. Because if there is any open door, he sees whether you are having some struggle, he will attack you on that area. So you have to keep renew your mind continuously with the word of God. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So you have struggle in certain things. You have struggle with different things, even if you become a born again Christian. It doesn't mean, but when you can come to know the truth, what Jesus did for you on Calvary, that is when you will get that freedom. You will be free completely in the name of Jesus Christ. You are renewing your mind. You're becoming more like Christ. Amen. So never call the grace of God that it is cheap. Amen. In Jesus Christ did not die in vain for sin or to Jesus deliver us from sin, took our old nature, which used to cause us to sin, and crucify it and give us a new nature, a new life. Amen. In Jesus' name. And then give us his Holy Spirit to walk with us here on this earth and make things easy for us. Amen. So he destroys Satan. He destroys sin because Satan is holding on sin, but he destroys Satan. He destroyed our sinful nature that used to cause us sin. That was like a devil nature. He destroyed it. So Satan has no control and no dominion over us again, amen, over our life again. That old nature has been crucified. That used to cause us to sin and make the devil to be our friend. Now he is not our friend anymore. The Holy Ghost now is our friend. He is our guide living now in us. So the Spirit of grace is now living in us to help us to navigate here on this earth, to do all things. The Bible says we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us, through Christ who lives in us, because Christ is in us, is the hope of glory. So that is my message today. I wanted just to encourage you. So stop, keep looking backward, like in the old covenant. And I don't say those old covenant were all types and shadow about Jesus Christ. It was just pointing to the cross. Now you have to go to the substance, the real substance in the new covenant, and read, see what Jesus finished for you on Calvary. Amen. In Jesus' name, keep looking backward. The Holy Spirit told me, say, people who keep looking backward as if Jesus did not die, that is a sin. That is a sin. Looking backward is a sin. That means you are frustrating the grace of God in your life. Amen. As if Jesus did not die and Jesus did not finish your work on Calvary. As if you are still an old covenant Christian like Abraham and all the other apostles where they were looking for Jesus to go to the cross. Jesus has already gone to the cross. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now the work has been finished. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory be to God. So God bless you. In the name of Jesus, put the whole armor of God. Fight the good fight of faith and lay hold of eternal life in the name of Jesus. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for all my new subscribers and the old subscribers. God bless you. I cover every one of you with the blood of the Lord Jesus in Jesus' name. Now we are under God's favor, under God's grace. No judgment again, no condemnation again. Hallelujah. Now we are under God's grace. That is why the Bible says in Romans 6 that we are not under the law again. That means we have to keep good all these things. If we don't keep it, oh, we'll have this trouble. No, we are under God's favor and under God's grace. So don't frustrate God's grace in your life in the name of Jesus Christ by looking backward, because looking backward is a sin to God in the eyes of the Spirit of grace in Jesus' name. Thank you and God bless you.